Okay, so thank you for coming. Today is a Tuesday, August 10th. This is a review of a self-test. I'm going to use two examples, and I'm seeking the more interactiveness, the question and answer. So it's more like we'll be able to learn together rather than one-way download. So first of all, thank you so much for submitting some of the results. And then I'd like to share that first. And I will show you how I go about. And it's not just one way, but just an example how you go into read yours. Just one of the example of how. Okay. So I'm going to cover this example one first. Can everybody see it? I don't hear.
Yes, anything. I can see.
You can see. Okay, good. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I didn't hear any feedback, so it just worried me for a second. Okay, so this is a result study with a sphere, triangle, and this teardrop shape. And then I love the teardrop analysis the most, but then it is important to go through from top down. The trick is, at least what I do is I look at the triangle first just to see where we are at, where am I at this, you know, in terms of the grand scheme of the journey. Now, I just want to be a little bit more talk about from the bird's eye view. Some of you remember that I said, you are one aspect of many. So I am here, one of my many other aspects. And then if you're human, if you came is here in a human blueprint, you have a minimum of over 1700 self in a various different time space vector. So this is a one of me, and one of me could be more in advanced place, and one of me are much more in an early stage. But regardless of it, is the whole goal is to every aspect of me will become, you know, pointed to the same direction at you know, the maximum optimum maturity of spirituality, for all of my aspect to come together in an ascent or go to the next evolutional cycle. So in a sense that we don't need to get disappointed or overexcited about the scores, because, you know, this is one of many of us, right? So first things I want to say, you know, don't be too dramatic to looking at these things. And the second things I want to say is that this number reflect how you answer to the question clearly. So if, let's say if I pretend, you know, let's say I am pretend, okay, this seems to be supposed to be the better answer, right? I'm already telling a little lie to myself, and that's not reflecting the actual score. So, you know, we all want to make sure this is brutally honest. And sometimes you don't know what is honest as you're taking a test, right? So I have to emphasize, it's okay to go back again to the question. Okay, I really, really want to be honest, because I really sincerely want to know where I'm at and which area that I need to improve upon. And it is okay to do that. And wait a minute, that doesn't make sense to me. And going back, the first time I took, I thought it was very easy. Well, I thought I could have a good score. I didn't really pay too much attention and just move on my life. And then later on, and darn on me, wow, this is actually really, you know, great test. Was I really honest? And I went back, and I wish I really kept my original score, because it really showed, you know, how I shifted, or how I changed. So I really encourage you to keep this, no matter how you think of it right now, keep it, you know. The second thing I would like to say is that I think some of you in a chat room is brilliant, because if I took this, like let's say when I was really working hard, you know, 3D, I definitely answered many of the questions very differently. And I'm curious, I went back to, you know, turn back time, like 10 years before or something, 15 years ago of me, I still remember how my belief system, and it goes through that question, how that's going to look like. And that's really, you know, revealing things. And now it's that Saturn is kind of in a perfect area for us to kind of review and reflect, depending on your natal chart though. But, you know, it's a lot of planet literal grading. So it is a good time to for us to kind of review and reflect our life, the section of life. It is a learning piece of experience. So definitely I recommend if you have a time to do it. Okay, so let's come back to this result. The step two triangle analysis here is I see the not page, well, first, you know, the number, the 80, that's pretty, you know, mediumly good weight, right? It's not too skimpy, like not like less than 60 or 50, and not too heavy, you know, over 90. You know, it's a good amount, good weight. And here I look at any peak in a valley, right? Not so much, really. I mean, if I really gonna analyze it, maybe this portion is a little heavy, but the rest of them has a very good score. Now, this is how you read it, is a current. The energy comes from here, Rishi level, and going down this way, okay? So here is a little bit more energy, the pulled a little bit, right? But the rest of them pretty equal. So this is a very good sign, and also the weight of the score. Based on this, I would say this individual is at the oversoul, where the journey, you know, cleared the soul level, and now it's oversoul. When you come to this maturity, the shadow work really start to reveal and have a significant impact on the individual's life, okay? So based on this, go upward, okay? Now I know this individual's soul, you know, like a maturity level, and go upward. And what I look at, is that any kind of extreme number is that scored less than 20, 23 or below, or the extremely high, you know, like a 36 and above. I don't immediately see that, and which is consistent to the finding below, because the majority of the victimizer programming seem to be cleared at each level of the soul journey. Now, I'm gonna look at the next as a balance, because this is what we like to achieve. The balance of those sphere, okay? So the one on the top is my new point, where those two polarity come together. And then also this is the one, the parent that bring, you know, burst into the two polarity, two opposing energy. But also those two opposing come together and the birthing to this. So depending on how you see, just the parents, but also the child, product of two, okay, depending on how, you know, which sequence you're gonna see. And on the bottom of the sphere is opposing polarity. And the left side of ERA, which is a more feminine expression or magnetic pole. And the right side is a masculine expression of a more electric pole, electric and magnetic, you know, so it's opposing polarity. So in a perfect world, those three scores are gonna be relatively close to each other, almost like the same, right? That's it's a, you know, perfect trinity balance. Now I'm gonna just kind of look through just each section, right? 25, 27, 28, 26, 26, 28 is almost perfect right here, pretty close here also. And then when I come here, I notice there's a 25 and 32, that's probably the biggest differences. So I make a note over here, and it happened to be this individual or the soul journey is at here. So this correspond. So I will pay great attention on the node 9, node 7, and node 8 will be, you know, by default will be deleted. So we all gonna look at those node 9, 7, 8, but specific attention to 9 and 7. So make note of that. Node 9, node 7. Okay. And I can move on to here. And it's a very balanced, right? Relatively high side here, but you know, very balanced. Okay. So we're gonna just kind of stop here. And then everybody has this seat. Let me just share. Hopefully somebody remember node 9 and 7. Okay. In triangles, third, that's easy to remember. Let me share another seat. Where did it go? There you go. All right. Now, so that triangle, what happened here? What happened, triangle? Triangle, okay. Number 3. Did I skip? Yeah. Go back. All right, here, the number 3. Okay. So the score, I am fully awake, right? That's pretty great feeling. This shows that your concern have shifted very fully from the concern of the external to the internal world toward the area of your highest expression. It would not be unusual if this period of life seemed to contain great change and not a little sacrifice, as your own frequency shift produced the inevitable fallout while attracting new and better potential. If the triangle 3 is a high score, you have nearly begun to master personal power in relationship with the outer world. You have learned to differentiate between higher love and controlling love, soft love and tough love. Finally beginning to break free from victimizer game at last. So this is a kind of, finally I'm seeing, you know, toward the end of the tunnel kind of thing. Now, when I said power node go into bring this individual to even a higher, the avatar consciousness. Okay, so let's take a look at this node number 7, right? So I want to look at the 9 first, because 9 is really the one that putting it together. It's my new one that it's basically signifying the result of the entire oversoul energy. So the node is here. That can somebody read this for me? If anybody could see the screen, okay.
I think I can read it now. I had it enlarged. So power node 9. Mm-hmm. Okay. The wizard or the sorcerer, the destructive versus creative potential interplay to create either a magical realization of the counterparts of one which is manifest darker applications of creativity. As an area of weakness, this persona can be portrayed as one who transforms better into lesser options. We engage in such when we belittle ourselves or another, reducing rather than increasing potential with the effect of reducing our own self-esteem. The sorcerer represents that part of ourselves which creates illness, disease, and represents the polar opposite of the Christos principle. Addictions, power, drug, self-delusion or dishonesty, goals, transformation, fear, evil sorcery, issues of transform, transmute, response, align self with Christos. So I'm not understanding that part. So it says the sorcerer represents that part of ourselves which creates illness, disease, and represents the polar opposite of the Christos principle. So are these exact examples, I guess, of the opposite of the Christos principle? So power, drugs, self-delusion, evil sorcery. But I don't understand, because transformation would not be the opposite, would it? Nor would transforming and transmuting. I'm confused by this part. And personal power aligns. So I'm confused by this part.
Okay. So basically it describing what is manifest as. So the manifest as addiction is power struggle. you know, use of a drug and, you know, dishonest self-delusion. Those are the ones that basically come as a shadow form.
Mm-hmm.
The goal of this individual is to transform such
thing. Ah, okay.
Yeah, that's how you read this one. So for any, every section. So the key fear here is the evil and sorcery. So what they are saying that the evil is, if you look at this word, the opposite word to live.
Mm-hmm.
So response aligns up with crystal. Crystal's principle is perpetual eternal life with joy. So that is a crystal's principle, and evil is the one against it. It's not like an evil, like a monster evil, but it's a limited finite system. You know, fight for resource control and don't, you know, the divine and conquer. That is all is anti-crystal's principle. And a sorcery is one of those listed as, right? It's if it's expressed in a polarity, a binary way, it creates basically illness, dis-ease, right? Dis-ease is not at ease. So that's how you read in this section. The virtue is basically to cultivate the personal power. So this is a tough one though. It's not easy. That's why it's good to kind of stop and think, what does it really mean, right?
So you chose this one because power node, I don't have that sheet up now, but the power node 9 number was lower.
So yeah, so this is the place of the triangle's third from the left. And based on the score, power node 9, and then, okay, let me just go back.
You mentioned node 7.
Yeah, 9 was the lowest, right? Mm. And 32 was too overexpressed compared to the less. So it's good to read 9 first, because 9 that was the product of 2, and then go to the each one. The one is lower with the power node 7. So the Pam, if you don't mind, if you could read this one too, may as well.
Sure. 7, you mean?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, wait. I gotta get back to that page.
Are you okay? Or did I lose Pam?
Oh, sorry about that. By mistake. Ah, okay. Power node 7, the compulsive destroyer. If deep imbalances exist in the previous 3 areas, then there is every likelihood that weakness here will manifest in extended self-destructive behaviors manifested by addictions, compulsiveness, or any activity which undermines intimacy, career success, or self-esteem. Frequently, these lead to physical and emotional abuse of others. This is so fascinating. Okay, so, and here the addictions are self-destructive habits, soul suicide. The goal is catharsis. The fear is fear of the God self. The issue is to find clarity and resolve. The response is surrender to strength in vulnerability, and the virtue to achieve or strive for is humility.
Yeah. Wow. So it is a good one. And then so that was expressed more, right? We did more. And we kind of have to read a power node 8 because it's part of it. But this was the most neutral one. I don't know, Pam, you want to keep reading or somebody else could read.
I don't mind unless somebody wants to.
If you don't mind, I would ask you.
Sure.
Thank you.
But which one? Because you did
8.
8. Okay, because that's all part of that same 7, 8, 9. Okay.
Yeah.
So 8 is the obsessive projectionist.
Mm-hmm.
Here the shadow works the persona in a way where life is perceived as meaningless or empty unless there is a project, challenge, or a new thing to do. Wow. Okay. Low boredom thresholds and a lack of awareness of the inner worlds characterize such tendencies. The archetype tends to express this deep inner emptiness through obsessive projection, creation of so many possibilities that none can be acted upon fully. Wow, this is so me. Okay, there's a close similarity to the woman who got pregnant every time she felt life to be meaningless. Addiction is to work, creativity to pass the time. The goal is self-identity. The fear is lack of authenticity. The issue is recognition that it is part of self. Okay, the issue is, in other words, recognition that this obsessive projectionist is part of the self, I guess, because we're supposed to embrace our shadows. Is that correct? So recognition of this. Response is self-acceptance, and the virtue to strive for is individuality and vocational identification. That's interesting. Oh, okay.
Yeah, so thank you. So this is deep though, right? And I have to say, rereading this particular section based on example, that doesn't mean just individualism only one facing, because we all have a part of all of these things in here. And then I think this is this multidimensional thing. And what is deep about it, just let me go back to each one itself is something that we need to think for, you know, deeply, you know, what does it mean? How that's going to apply to me? And so what, you know, a lot of things that we're going to be needed to answer individually, also as a group to see here as a perspective to clarify into the, we could ask a better question. But what I'm going to like to go back here is that, so here, I mean, this person has a very good score. I'm just nitpicking here, you know, normally this is okay. You are just journey and move on to next. Just because we are, we want a betterment ourselves and also understand how to read this result. That's why I'm digging into. Normally, I'm not going to pay too much attention because it's all equally distributed. Although this is a discrepancy here, right? So for this person to getting closer to Trinity level, yes, then we don't, you know, kind of read this section a couple of times, then it has, I'm going to apply yes, no. And we say, if it's yes, it's going to applicable, all right. There's how to do it. It's right there. So that's, you know, taking you know, whatever the methodology that work for you, because since this person already overcome those power nodes in the previous section, now we have a better assessment tool, so it should be easier. I want to say though, because of this is a multidimensional test, this energy is coming from not just from here now, but it's coming from the oversoul level. So meaning is a couple of different things. The one is not necessarily this lifetime, okay, but somewhere else. And if where is it somewhere else? Actually, there's another reference point you could look into if you're really curious about where it's coming from, but it's coming from far larger area of the more collective, that this self experience as a more like a collective level. Okay, so this is a kind of like a heavy things that possibly that's not something that, you know, you try to find and analyze. Perhaps you may not be able to analyze where this coming from because it's pretty, you could say pretty deep, coming from very deep area, or coming from the collective experience, the time period or experience in a mass level. Okay, that is something you are basically transmuting from here. But it doesn't matter if you solve here, it will solve that distance. So this is another incredible thing about it, right? You here impact all those, but also collective experience here impact this way. It's vice versa. Well, we could only deal with the one we could deal with. So I just wanted to say that. I mean, that's how also you could look at it too, okay? Because this is a multidimensional test. That's why it's real deep. Normally, I emphasize, I'm just gonna go over very in detail because of the more educational purpose here. and everybody got your own score, and hopefully the example help. I will have to say this example may not help many of you because it's pretty perfect, right? And a good example usually not really helpful for some time, but nevertheless, it's always good to see the good result. Now, the teardrop analysis is interesting. And if you look at this, again, this is pretty equally distributed, right? In a both, but there's nothing one color is dominant. So I would say pink and yellow is a dominant, right? And then you could lead what is the best way for this individual to grow, you know, preferred running style, right? And it's just hearing, and this is color, right? That's so this individual seer and be able to hear. Now, perhaps this area going to the next one to be developed. This is a direct cognition. So this is kind of setting up for the individual to learn more. It's to kind of inner wisdom, tapping into the inner wisdom, aligning yourself with inner God self, right? To have a direct cognition, which is interesting because that's what the, one of the theme, right? One of the topic to work on, if you remember the node analysis of nine. Let's see. Okay, so here is the one that goes the fear toward God self, right? Which is kind of correspond to inner knowingness, direct cognition, align self with Christos, personal power. So it's all kind of related to each other. So as this individual overcome all those issues and transform the power and transmute the power of the fear, right? And become owning a personal power, aligns himself with a Christos through self-acceptance, and then also that through, you know, surrender to the vulnerability. It is okay to be vulnerable. And once we be able to balance those energy, have a direct cognition with the book father. So it is kind of brilliantly orchestrated things. It's very subtle, this example. All right. Any question so far?
I did write down some questions. I'm not sure if you've answered them. Wait. So we're striving to have this kind of balance that you see here, which is very unusual, but that's what we're striving for. And the higher numbers reflect that we're in the right direction or not necessarily?
No, not necessarily. You don't want to have a too high or too low.
Okay.
We're looking at the balance, and but it's needed some kind of weight, you know. Let's see. There is some example that here. You could tell this is an extreme example. Now this is, if you look at this, you know, 50, right? Highest is 61, and then the last node is 39. That's really low. Okay, so this is the very beginning. So that's very low. That make actually significant. It's you know, the number itself. But what are you looking for is the balance between those three spheres. Now, I don't think anyone is in this category. When you come to the class, if somebody has this kind of low score, you're probably coming to my class for fun or maybe taking other classes also. That's my so very few people are gonna have this type of score, I'd imagine. All right. Now, so that's hopefully that's the answer. I'm looking more at the balance. Let's see here. I could move to the next example, but
can I just ask you to that person who you just reviewed, if they had balance, they have balance in the other power nodes, the other groups of three circles, then they would be saying to themselves that power nodes 7, 8, and 9 is where their work right now.
Yes.
Is okay. And that they can, they're in pretty good place with the others. But once you satisfy the 7, 8, and 9, that you might be going back to tweak some of the others, in other words, for future growth?
Yeah, that's a good question, though. You know, you never know, because each time you shift and then, you know, hopefully it's going to go integrate into, right? And then the expectation is that you're going to avatar, like a next level. You know, that's what we kind of think, but we really don't know. That's really what are we looking for, though, right? We are looking for the disincarnate self going to go to avatar integration stage here.
And then when you get to the teardrops, do you want those to be balanced also?
Yes. Oh, yes, absolutely. Okay. Okay. That is the most important thing. It really is, it's a, you know, the balance. But then how to balance is actually, we're going to talk about a little bit more. It's a methodology I recommend. It's so simple that people may not going to believe it. But so that's a good thing about it. You know, how are you going to do about it in a teardrop if it's not, you know? First of all, just teardrop will show you your tendency. So you could use as a guide, okay, that's how I learn. My preferred running style now is this.
And oh, my affiliation. Yeah. Okay. So that's my last question. I'm sorry to interrupt, but okay. If say your score is higher in sound versus direct cognition or visual, that would mean that at this time that sound may be more healing for you.
Absolutely. Your tendency to align yourself and learn from the sound. So it's not, yeah.
Okay.
Exactly. So I'm probably going to move to the next example that may help that, you know, you're seeing different example really help. So let me share that. Let me see. Oh, here. Am I sharing it? Let me just close this. So sometimes I don't know.
We can see.
Everybody looking at it.
And yeah.
Mine is very small. Zoom in. Okay, now it's zooming too much. Sorry. Okay. All right. Can everybody see the sphere and triangle?
Yes.
Okay. Good. So I like this particular example because it's a I think it's in the sense that many of us going through this phase. And then it is a very important phase. So again, I told you that I look at the triangle first and I look through from left to right and I look through the bar in a peak and a valley. So I see the two peak, right? 1, 2, and then the valley here. And then there's some little, but you know, about the same, but it's a big thing is right here. So this is almost like a textbook example of the dark journey of the dark soul. It is going through the one of the big, huge transformation of the disincarnate. So once you're going through the 3D drama, you know, you grow and awake. And the next stage is actually quite a big, huge things. And this is what are happening. The soul is kind of awakening in going to engage even a higher calling. So, and this is a lot of, this is a time that has a lot of things going to happen in a personal life and also collective energy. Life become kind of, you know, upside down and emotional, become like a roller coaster kind of thing, you know. So it is something that, how do you say this? It's they're almost like a teenage period, you know, the life that you will never forget, but more like a spiritual stage rather than, you know, chronological age. It's a very important stage. How it read, again, the current, when I say current, it's energy. The energy coming from here, the Rishi level avatar, oversoul, soul, incarnate. So this is a direction. What is happening here is that you stop here and it really, it can go right through it because here's some block and because it's a lot of polarized, you know, internal, the soul is basically fighting itself, internal conflict, the soul level. So there is the current, not all the current is go, but the oversoul is really trying to help, right? Try to give the direction. So this is why the energy stuck, energy kind of stored here. And now here, the incarnate, the life is being overcome so that this level is satisfied. So again, this one is not really depleted. This is a very important profile to read. And it's not too uncommon for them. Even a spiritually advanced people has this profile because this seem to be come and go. It's not like, okay, I overcame here already. No, this was me before. I'm here now. I'm just going here. Not necessarily. It's sometimes we go back and forth here many, many times. Kind of quite annoying, but because of it, you're dealing with a different incarnate life and karma, you know, each time it's really different. You know, you're not going backward. It's just, it's a snapshot of you now. That doesn't mean that, you know, that you, if you, let's say you don't have this pattern now, that doesn't mean you don't have it in your future. That's what I wanted to say. And that doesn't mean you're going backward either. So this is why I'm saying that you don't need to be too overexcited or too over depressed by looking at the number. We can shift. So this is the one big thing I noticed, right? Right off the chart. Okay, so this individual is suffering, right? Especially if this is the first time. If it's not the first time, the fifth and sixth time, okay, I got this. I know I've been here before. You know, how can I enjoy maximally why I'm, you know, overcoming this? So this is becoming a little bit different kind of experience, but nevertheless, it's a challenge. So we're going to go look up back to the sphere. Is there anything that require immediate attention, which is a score lower than 20 or 23? So you're going to see here that all the score is around, you know, not below the 20, but it's an upper level of the victimizer program. So the node, I will circle node 4, 5, 6 in a red, right? Pretty significant node. The persona is expressing. So that's something that you need to study more of. Then I'm gonna look the adjacent spheres pairs, the trinity with spheres. I look here, very balanced. A little less than a money energy, but nevertheless, it's okay. And I look at the here. So those two are balanced, but the Manu energy, the product is slightly weak, but it is not as severe as it's in the main. Well, actually this is within the ecosystem. It's kind of well balanced actually, right? It just overall scores it all. Okay. So the last one, it's also, that's another one that usually happens when this happened and just something happened here as well. So those two are equal, but this Manu is quite weak, right? So that's also a circle. So that's a power node 12. So those are actually related probably. So I will circle power node 4, 5, 6, and 12. Okay, that's something we need to, you know, pay attention to. Now let's go here through, I'm looking at it here, and this is a perfect example of the one expression is very stronger than other two, which is ERA, which is a divine feminine energy. So it is, the sound is quite beautiful, and also it also represents the vibration. Energy of vibration, counterclockwise energy. This is when you express when moon comes up in the night, right? It is receiving end. but also create a space without the sound, without the vibration, without the ERA energy. There's no existence of light. Sound comes before the light. The sound, the vibration create the space. Before, there's no space. Without the space, there's no distance. There's no basically distance for the light to travel. There's no light. So it is equally important, but then we tend to ignore the sound aspect and all light. It's a light, you know, go to the light. What happened to the sound? You know, it is, there has to be sound, have to be before the light. So the sound is always, you know, kind of signify the divine mother principle, right? Mother. Those individuals are be able to attune to the sound. So let's say if you're gonna receive the message, likely this person will hear before see it. So that's how you kind of interpret this. Also, in a higher dimension, the sound, okay, higher dimensional sound translate here as a saint, scent, excuse me, scent. So it is interesting that people who does singing bowl kind of things, right? And also prone to kind of gravitate toward essential oil kind of things. Pay attention to what are you inclining to. If you love essential oil, likely probably like a singing bowl or some kind of sound therapy, or you really enjoy that particular music, or you're sensitive to the sound, it actually cross the nervous system cross, which is kind of not well-known fact, but more and more I think of it, I think I feel it's very true, at least to me. So the healing is good to use essential oil and sound for this case, but also learn and excel, right? And kind of learning with sound. So those person will be, this individual will be great to do the a lot of person, singing person, to heal the, you know, many aspect of a persona or power node. Also, there are so many things. It's let's take a look because it's pretty strongly expressed ERA. I like to read down. Where did it go? Is this this one? Let's try this. I like to have a one volunteer to read the ERA section, which is pretty awesome. Pink, I think it's here. Let me, yeah. Ooh, I'm not sure. Should I enlarge this so that people could actually see it, or? It's too long for the person to read, maybe. So I'm just gonna read the first one, and if somebody could read a pink section of pink, which is the ERA section, would be wonderful. Let me make it. Is it? Can everybody see this, or it's too small?
I can see.
Okay, thank you.
I can see.
Thank you. The analysis here, it's called capstone. Capstone is used for the top of the pyramid, but it's a signify the most important things, right? For the rest of the structure. And then here it's also the same thing. This is a mutable Rishi family stone. So it's not necessarily you actually came from this family, but right now your energy is aligned to this. There's another analysis you can do to identify your, you know, actual receive family, but we're not covering here at this time, maybe later. So if you have a very strongly expressed number, the capstone now for you is this. Okay? So which primary life source current you are most susceptible to, which means you're gonna be needing, you right now, this receive family is helping you to grow farther. Now, looking into the array of a party present in one's personal field. So a party is basically, you could think of a receptor for this and then other dimensional things. And we have over 1,000 a party, but depending on the persons, you know, the number or percentage of parties being, you know, open or operational is up to that person. This is why we perceive things differently. But anyway, it allows you to identify the misalignment, if any. The misalignment is the area that the perception and the related thought do not align with the divine blueprint. The outcome can be viewed within this life context, as well as being representative of the multidimensional composition of the expanded self across all time vectors. So this is what I'm talking about, the example, the last example, when the individual was dealing with the oversoul. This is exactly what it was basically talking about. You may utilize the following information to create your own technology to upweight the deficient area. But this is something that, you know, you are the scientist, you are the one healer of a master healer to create your own cocktail by knowing which one is, you know, the line at this time the most. So can somebody read this section for this, maybe just this paragraph up to here?
I can read it.
Thank you.
Pink, teardrop pink 1, 4, 7, 10 represent female divine mother characteristics, reflecting the nature of Ira and associated subfrequency. Particum currents, these are magnetic, pulling, contracting, passive, counterclockwise, rotating, and associated with sound, sounds, and the violent flame frequencies of the Ki-Ra-Sha. Too little Ira is reflected by scores below 20. If this is the highest score, you belong to Brahma Christos race line. Each sphere corresponds to a density level, 1, density 1, 4 equals density 2, 7 equals density 3, 10 equals density 4, 5 equals density 12. Therefore, deficiencies associated with any particular density level can be addressed by a frequency diet, which incorporates more of such deficient frequencies. Ira intake can be maximized by breathing. Inhale more slowly and more deeply. Hold briefly. Exhale fast, short, and sharp. Too much Ira, as imbalance, man A or man U, would imply poor motivation, work ethic, proneness to being victimized, and a tendency for manipulative, selfless behaviors. Subfrequencies are density 1, chi, density 2, prana, density 3, mira, density 4, ta, density 5, sha, and each being rays 1, 4, 7, 10, and 15 respectively, and associated colors, dark sapphire, pale pink, violet flame. 15, violet flame, era, pale pink tone, ta, sha, sound. You may use both color and tone to bring this frequency more into your field.
Wow, thank you. And if you don't mind, the lessons as well, David.
Lessons: developing self-containment and internalization of personal power, directing energy and power inward, management of personal energy and hence management of the many selves within, development of physical body mastery, learning to receive unconditionally, learning to love oneself unconditionally, transmuting passive impulse to assertive action. overcoming victim consciousness through embodiment of its opposite expression, bringing body and spirit into more effective balance, developing inner self, particularly one's inner auditory sense, learning to respect the boundaries and spiritual rights of others. Affiliations: Ascended Masters Collective, the Ramayanas, Rishi Family, Amethyst Order, Bruno, Crystal's Founders Race, Raha Rama, Flame Group, Violent Flame, Primary Rake Colors, D15, Pale Magneta, Pink Plus, D10, Dark Sapphire Blue, Primary Ray Tones, Kusha Ta, Primary Contact Ray, Susceptible to Pale Magneta Pink Plus, Dark Sapphire Blue Plus Red, Density 15 plus 10 plus 1. Universal Karmic Cycle Affiliation, Tara Pleiades. Audio dominant, you work well with sound. You may balance it with visual mana energy for balance.
Thank you very much. I know there's some interesting word here and there. David was saying, what is that? But you read it very well. Thank you so much. So it's a lot to write here, but I think it's a good thing is that they're telling you how to work with the sound and the color. And you know, you could apply to actually a lot of different things. Now it's interesting because I'm a little bit more earway dominant. So what are you, just sharing how I utilize this information into my daily, you know, some of the things. Let's say if I want to jog the park in a circle, because I'm a tendency to be ERA, I automatically go into counterclockwise running. I notice, wait a minute, am I? Yes, every time I go in counterclockwise. So wait a minute, okay. I want to supplement myself with, money energy. Man A is clockwise, you know, the masculine energy. So I'm going to run, you know, jog clockwise, right? Just to balance myself. You know, that's how simple that could be achieved. And then I'm going to use a little bit more breathing, you know, breathing more. I'm going to be focusing on exhaling more deeply, slowly, and inhaling shallowly, because I like to bring more mana energy into me. So I work well in the morning, because that's like a little bit lacking in me. So I tend to get up, I be more happy in the morning, right? And supplement my balance, and then, you know, put me in a more better mood. So something like that, you know, it's something that's probably, you know, we do, but in consciously working toward, you know, but again, it'll give you a little bit different satisfaction and more consciously develop, you know, your inner knowingness. And this is a very good section, and everybody got at least one section. So I recommend you going back to your teardrop and lead, you know, it is a lot of good information. But now some of them may be a little bit foreign. So I just kind of, you know, if you have a question, it's a really good time to ask, because I don't know how to, I probably skip, you know, how people lead and skip some area. Any question in here? Is it like too much information, to overwhelmed, or are you guys okay?
I think it's completely awesome. I have a question, but go ahead, David, is that you?
Yeah, I was wondering, what do you focus on if the flame is balanced?
The teardrop being balanced?
Yeah, then what do you, look at?
If those three teardrop shape is completely balanced, That's an awesome thing. So I probably gonna read all of it, you know, and nothing in particular because, I forgot. No. If there's everything balanced, this is the one that's important. Hold on. I almost wanted to say something. You're gonna read a Manu, the last one, the blue. This one is for you. Okay. Likely you are this. If this is all balanced up for you, you're gonna read a blue. This is like it said blue, but it's more like turquoise blue, a little shade of emerald green.
Okay, so it's the mixture of the three colors.
Mm-hmm. Because those two, the yellow and the pink, came out from here. So, you know, if it's all balanced, that means you are blue.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's tricky, right? Uh-huh. It's a 13, it's a dimension 13, but actually it's really also dimension, next dimension up. So I guess I don't want you to confuse, but basically this is the first one of all the three.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good question. Anybody else? Okay, let me see, did I miss something? And let's go back. Anybody else ask a question? I covered those two examples because those two individuals submitted. And then I know some people did the private session and go over. Now that's really up to the person's preference, really. And let me see if I miss anything else. Yeah, so the rest of the thing you could do, right? There's a clearly, there's a lower score, or if you're very meticulous, perfectionist, well, you have to be careful if you use those words because they criticize there in there. But if, you know, it's just kind of a little more analytical, you know, mark those number that it's a little bit higher end or lower end, right? And then the area that not in a balance, the power node in a balance. And you're just gonna go read there and then see, you know, which part is your, you know, issue and how to overcome, right? And this is actually the place to start with and continue on. Now, how actually going into deal in a daily basis? That's something that we all kind of, you know, consciously going to, right, think and act upon. And this is really the actual meat. And you will be so fortunate if you have someone to talk about this, right? And kind of throw out the idea and back and forth. If you have a person like that, you know, congratulations, you know, you're setting yourself up for the success. Because what happening is it's just, you know, okay, sometime I do it and sometime and mostly not. And we kind of put that in a back pocket and totally forget about it until something happened. It's a good thing. It's just like a kind of building your strengths, you know, just do gently, but, you know, consistently walk toward without penalizing yourself, without, you know, overindulging, you know, that kind of things, and try to have some happy medium fun in it. So we actually continue work on it. So that's a kind of, you know, my suggestion, and I'm definitely working on this with you. So please think that, please don't, I hope I didn't come out with like very condensating or, you know, I'm here and you're there, that kind of thing. It's we are all in the same soup, really. I have a lot of things I need to correct, and hopefully this was a little bit more helpful and tangible. All right. So I'm gonna stop here. And if you have any more question or comment, I'm probably gonna end this right here though. Anyone else, any words?
I just wanna thank you. Thank you so much.
You're very, very welcome. All right. Then we have a still chat room going on, so good to chime in. And hey, thank you so much for showing up and have a great evening. Oh, I'm gonna stop the recording here. I just want to say something. Just one thing. Stop the